And finally, as I mentioned before, there is a database called configuration that if you're a privileged user, you'll be able to see this. This configuration is where we store those things that are required for us to store for our local applications to work. So we're using AF as a repository for those things that we need to keep track of ourselves. So the asset database is the natural place to put that. That's why we ask you not to touch anything in this OSIsoft database if you do have access to it. Now here's how we refer to this in our documentation. We're saying this configuration database is used by data directory clients as they interact with the data directory. Now this is the first time in this class we've referred to AF as a data directory. And we call it an asset database. Data directory is a great term to describe what people are doing with AF. They're using it as a directory for data. All those different client applications that are going to require that we store things locally, I shouldn't say locally, but globally, for all users to get access to. We are going to store that in this reserved database. So that's why we ask you not to use it for any of your own application data.